Hi guys, it's Adam. Welcome back. Some of you asked me to build a real GPS locator for the quadcopters, for example. So to do that, you need another chip, you need another board. So I had purchased some board with the chip SIM808, which actually costs something like $10. And that's the cheapest I could find. I must admit that this one is the cheapest. So it is from AND Global, and the name is BK808 version 2 or something like this. You can search for it on AliExpress. So this one also differs a bit because it doesn't have a ring signal here. So basically, you cannot use an interrupt to wake up the Atmega, the MCU that will be controlling this board. Also, it requires to have external antennas. So, like here, you see the GSM antenna, the BT Bluetooth. So, I'm not using this one. So, the GPS antenna also is needed. And the other thing is that this board is not exactly well designed. So, to make it work, I needed to solder another capacitor here, so it's connected in parallel to the existing electrolytic capacitor. Otherwise, if you try to run it, it will simply not register to the GSM network because it will be constantly restarting itself. So you need to keep that in mind, that you need this, you really need this capacitor if you intend to use this this particular board. So maybe other are better constructed, but this one, yeah, this is shit. But let's see if it's working then in a minute. Okay, so it has a ordinary pin connector, so we'll be using this to attach to the main board, I would say. So I have a second board here with the SIM, and when I detach the board, you will see the ARDUINO UNO chip, so Atmega 328. With some diodes and capacitors, simply speaking, they are used only to provide a 3.3 voltage to this chip, because this one will be using TTL levels with the 3.3 logic. So even though this board is actually powered from the 5 volts up to 10 volts, so there's a linear power regulator here, so this is a LM1804, which actually drops the voltage to the 4 volts. So that's the voltage, that the same voltage as SIM800L is using. So basically, you need to adapt your design to work with 3.3 volt logic. So if you've done it, then you are ready to go and you can connect this one. Okay, so as you can see, I have a main board with Atmega, I have a breadboard with the SIM808, so this one is having, what about this chip? So this chip is slightly better than the previous one, the SIM800L, because this one is not only having a 2G network connectivity, but it also has a Bluetooth, it also has a GPS inside. And it also has a GNSS, so which is the new standard satellite system, positioning satellite system in Europe. So it is something new. So I was glad that I bought something that could be used in the future with not only GPS but GNSS. So what other? You need to buy two antennas. So I have the cheapest I could find. So this is something like less than $2. So this is a GPS ceramic, GPS passive antenna. So you need that if you want to catch the satellite signal. So without that, it is the functionality would be limited only to the GSM network. So for GSM network, I also have some kind of antennas. This one costs something like $0.50. I believe so. It is a 1.5 inch long, and both antennas are using something called IPEX connector or UFL. You may also find the name UFL. So you need to search for these antennas. So I'm not aware about using active GPS antenna, but I found on the internet that some guys are using active antennas, but they need to adapt some board, so they need to add some, I would say, powering resistor to this socket to make it work. So I only tried with the passive. Okay, so maybe let's turn it on. We'll see if there's any difference according to the SIM 800. So I will attach my board here, so let's turn it on. Yeah, also I have a USB power bank, sorry. We'll be using this to power the device. Okay, as you can see, there are two LED indicators. So one is simply the power on indicator, and at the beginning I suggest you to get rid of this LED, because it is actually consuming some power. So if you intend to use it in a sleep mode, for sure you will need to solder this one out. And this one, the second LED, is actually the same indicator as in SIM 800L, so it simply tells you if the device registered in 2G network, or if it's using GPRS, or if it's unable to register, and some basic informations. Like I mentioned before, so you really need this capacitor here, because otherwise the LED would be constantly blinking fast, meaning that there's no possibility to register to the network, and basically it will be due to the device, the board with SIM 808, constantly restarting itself in a loop. So you really need to put this one in. I don't know about the other boards, probably they are well designed, much more. But this was the cheapest one, yeah, keep that in mind. So this is only $10 here. Okay guys, so maybe I should go outside to show you how this GPS really works. Yes, so we're gonna meet in a second. Okay guys, I'm already outside, so I'm on my balcony and I will be trying to catch the GPS signal with the SIM 808 board connected to Atmega 328. So I'm using here the PoTi to show you what are the commands that are sent towards the SIM 808, and at the beginning we'll try to see what the MCU is sending, and after that we'll try the opposite way, I mean what SIM 808 is responding to the MCU. Okay, so as you can see, I'm also using this FTDI232 serial converter, USB to serial, just to have a serial port here, because I don't have one, so I need to use a converter. And the board, I already put that into some kind of case for the future. Okay, so maybe I shall put the device in the place that it could see the satellites. So give me one second. Okay, I think it is already in a good position, so I'll turn that one on. Okay, so the MCU is trying to contact the SIM 808 board after 10 seconds, so it's ATE 0, though, to disable the echo. Then it fixes the serial port speed to 9600. Then it simply turns on the radio, it's CFAN equals 1. We'll see if it is going to register to the network in a moment. Ok, okay, now it checks the pin, and then there's a something like, I don't know, 30 seconds or 1 minute to give it time to register to the 2G network. So we need to wait a bit. So be patient, please. Meantime, you can see the device, so it's right here. So now we are waiting. Okay, so seems that it's already registered because there's a program going further. Then it disables the GPS power, the GNSS chip power, and via the command AT plus CS CLK equals one, it goes to the sleep mode. So to go into the sleep mode, this one needs really to have a DTR line high, because otherwise it won't got go, it won't be able to go into the sleep mode. Okay, now it's in the sleep mode, so I'll now try to call it. So it works simply the same way as the previous GPS GSM locator tracker, whatever you call it. So it awaits until you call it via mobile. So I will now try to call it. I have my mobile here, so hold on. Okay, let's call it. Now we are calling. Okay, it goes out of the sleep mode, it disconnects the call, and then it tries to provision GPRS data for the further use in case we don't find the satellite. So if we don't find the satellite, it simply will pull the data from the 2G cell and send it back over text message. Right now it restarts the GPS, it enables power of the GPS. So it is what you see here, so it enables a GPS and makes a cold start. Now it queries the status of the GPS every 15 seconds. So it will do this 40 times, so 40 times checking of the GPS status to be sure that we sacrifice appropriate amount of time to find the satellites. Okay, so now we need to check to wait a bit. So we see if it's going to fix to the satellites. Why we are calling this device, why it is not done automatically. So we need to somehow to tell the chip what is the MSISDN number that it should send back the SMS message. So you can hard code the data within it, like your private number, but it's better to have it quite universal, like waiting for SMS, for a text message, or waiting for a call to make it know what is the phone number that you're using. Okay, so we are waiting. So it was querying already four times, so 1 minute has passed. Now it's second minute, so I believe it's gonna take up to 3 to 4 minutes to fix on satellites. So we need to be patient though. If it's if it gets the fix, then it will send a CGPS inf message to get position of longitude and latitude, and then it will try to send you back those data over the text message. If it's not possible, I mean, if it's not possible to find the satellite, it will use the ordinary method, assisted GPS. So it will query the Google by the cell ID to find the GPS location of the nearest 2G tower. So that's the behavior it actually does. Okay, we are waiting. So I hope it will find something, because today is a bit cloudy and it is a passive antenna, so it requires to have a better signal. Let's wait. It should find something in a minute, I believe. constantly querying the GPS about the status, if it's already found some satellite data or not. So it takes some time for this to find. Hopefully it finds something here. Yeah, the other thing I have to mention, so in the code it waits for at least six satellites visible. So it needs six satellites to get out of this checking GPS loop. So otherwise it will simply wait until there are 40 attempts. So you may code this differently, so it's up to you. I was just hoping that six satellites would be sufficient to get a proper fix. But from what I know, four satellites are enough to get the fix. Okay, guys, thanks that you are patient. So after something like 6 or 5 minutes, it actually got the 3G fix on the GPS, and it sent the longitude and latitude with the Google Map link to my mobile. So after that was accomplished, it actually went back to the sleep mode, so with the CCA. Okay, so let me check the message that I got. Okay, so hold on please a bit, I need to enable GPRS, or LTE rather. Okay, so it simply says sends messages in such way, so you can see how it is working. And now I can query the, yeah, it's showing me some kind of location here. So I'm not quite sure about the accuracy of this device, so maybe I'm having a bad antenna, bad GPS maybe. Maybe it's time to invest some more money in this. But in total, this device, this whole project costs less than $20. Okay guys, so thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe, please give thumbs up, so I'll be having motivation to do something more interesting. And give me some comments, what you would like to see, what would you like me to construct. So bye bye, thanks very much.